This video is unlike any I've shared before. It's going to be a bit different, but I promise you it will provide you with an insane amount of value. I'm breaking down my exact client acquisition system I've used to generate well over $100,000 a year as a product photographer. The same system I've taught to dozens of students inside of Creative Biz Launch. Now, this video that I'm sharing with you today is actually a lesson from the program. This is an exclusive first look inside, as I've never shared a video with anyone other than my students. By the end of this video, you'll have a great overview of how to attract more clients than you know what to do with. We'll walk through the stages of the process, like prospecting, lead generation, sales calls, and more. This lesson wraps up with me discussing the paths a creative business can take, whether that's being a successful solopreneur or scaling your business and building out a team. All of this is taught inside Creative Biz Launch, but for now, I want you to see this lesson from Module 4. Keep in mind, this is a part of Module 4, so there's some context you'll be missing, but there's still plenty to learn. Let's dive in. Okay, Client Acquisition 101. Welcome to this part of the course. Let's make some money. But first off, we need to talk about one very important thing. I've talked about this before in the intro, but you are not owed clients. The world does not owe you anything. I don't care how good you are at your skill. It's your fault if you don't have clients. No one else's. Remember that. So, with that out of the way, let's make some money. We've been building up the base of our period all this time. Now it's time to execute and actually get our clients. This is my favorite section of the whole Creative Biz Launch system. It's the most fun for me. And honestly, the section alone is worth way more than the cost of Creative Biz Launch. The info here is gold. It will really transform your business. The struggle I hear the most is, how do I get clients? I hear this all the time from fellow photographers, fellow creatives. They struggle how to get clients. If you can solve for this question, all of your business problems will go away. At least most will, right? We've already been addressing this issue from the very start of this course, actually. How do I get clients is, one, you need a good website for it. You need to get a niche. You need an incredible offer. See, we've built that pyramid up, right? If you're in a niche, it's way easier to get clients than if you're broad. If you have a great offer, it's way easier to get clients than if you have a terrible offer, right? A website helps with that too. So now it's time to cash in on the work that we've done and show leads what we're capable of. Remember, leads are just people that are potentially going to buy our offer. The goal of this whole system is to turn strangers into paying clients. That's easier said than done, but we've already done a lot of the work. We have our offer, we have our niche. So now we just have to make that known. Clients are going to be the lifeblood of your business. Clients give you money. You need money to keep your business alive. So in turn, clients keep your business alive. Your business, it exists to help people. If you can't get clients, you won't be able to help people, right? At the end of the day, that's why you're in business. You want to be able to help people with your craft. And if you can't get clients, you won't help anyone. There are only four ways to actually get clients. One, reaching out to people you know. This is warm messaging. Two, posting to an audience that you know. This is organic social. Three, reaching out to people that you don't know. This is cold messaging. And four, posting to an audience that you don't know. This is paid advertising, right? So our system, the system I've developed, is teaching the most effective of these methods, cold messaging. Why are we doing cold messaging? Well, so warm messaging, this is reaching out to people that you know, but if you do a lot of warm messaging, leads will dry out fast and it's hard to build a client base by doing this. Organic social, it takes a very long time to build an audience that trusts you enough to buy from you. We'll get into building a brand later on in the course. We've already talked about that initially in Marketing 101, but we're going to be building this in the background as we're doing our cold messaging. Paid ads. Paid ads can be great. They are very expensive to get right. You'll need to spend at least $100 a day on testing ads for months before you really land on something that sticks. If you have a lot of capital to play around with, then this is effective, but I'm assuming as a solo entrepreneur, you don't have that capital. So that leads us to cold messaging. Cold messaging, it's very cheap to get leads. There are tens of thousands of leads out there in your niche. It's a simple method that you can repeat over and over again, and It's a great way to practice sales with little repercussion, right? So this is important because if we decide to go warm messaging, you're probably bad sales right now, but after you go through this course, you're gonna get good at sales. If we practice on people we know, we're gonna practice while we're still bad. You might as well practice on people you don't know, right? So let's look at our client acquisition system. Step one, create an offer. We have that, great. Step two, get eyeballs on that offer. Step three, create a call to action, book a call. Step four, sales call. Step five, send a proposal. Step six, close deal. Seven, fulfill on our offer. Sound simple enough? Let's go into these. Step one, create an offer. This will be an irresistible offer that stands out in the market. Step two will be to get eyeballs on that offer. This will be done through cold outreach, specifically cold email. This will have a hook. Your cold email will have a hook, a credibility statement, plus your offer. Step three, you're gonna have a call to action. So for cold outreach, this is going to be your ask. You're gonna be sending cold emails with your hook, credibility, and an ask. Your ask is going to be to book a call to learn more about your offer, pretty much. Step four is your sales call. So here, everyone that has a positive response to your cold outreach will hop on a sales call with you. On the sales call, you figure out their problems and then you propose your solution, your offer. The goal is to get them to ask for a project proposal on the sales call, right? They ask for a proposal. And step five, you send a proposal. So we're gonna learn how to create a proposal outlining your solution, your offer. Send that to a client to lock in a project. Step six will be closing that deal. So until someone signs your proposal, you don't have a deal. You're gonna follow up with that lead until you get a yes or a no. You're gonna continuously follow up. When someone says yes and they sign, you collect a 50% deposit right up there. And step seven is fulfilling on our offer. This is doing what you say you do, fulfilling on that offer. Let's look at a sales funnel. So a sales funnel looks like this. At the top here, we have getting eyeballs on our offer. So the eyeballs come in of those people. A few of them respond. Some say yes. Sales calls are down here. You send a proposal, you lock in your deal. So each step of the funnel has less and less people. The people who respond yes and hop on a call might not always want a proposal. The people that get a proposal might not always sign. So the funnel is shaped this way. This means it's a numbers game. You will get rejected a lot more than you think. And rejection is actually part of the game, right? So at the very start of the sales process, we're actually going to focus on getting people to say no. We're not focusing on getting people to say yes. This will just lead to disappointment. Your first goal is to get 100 no's. And when a no is part of the goal, you feel good when you get a no, right? So if we make our goal to get no's and then we get a yes, then we feel fantastic. And if we were to make our goal to get one yes, we're gonna deal with a lot of rejection. That's gonna wear on you. So right now, make it your goal to get those no's. That might sound counterintuitive, but really convince yourself that your goal is to get rejected. And if you do, then this process will go a lot easier. So our client acquisition system, creating an offer, that was module 3. Getting eyeballs on the offer, that's module 4. Create a call to action, book a call, module 4. Sales call, module 4. Send a proposal, same thing, close the deal. Module 4 as well. And finally, step 7, fulfill our offer. That's module 5, so that's coming up after these lessons. The client acquisition system is the most in-depth module in this whole program. It takes a while to get through it. There's a lot of moving parts, and they're all very important, so pay attention to every one of these videos. Let's look at some definitions. So I've been talking in terms of prospect leads and clients throughout this course, but to really put a definition to these, so a prospect is someone that can benefit from your service but doesn't know that you exist. A lead is someone who's expressed interest in your service. A client is someone who's agreed to work with you. For example, I'm a food and beverage product photographer. I know food and beverage brands can
benefit from my service. So if I reach out to a tea company, right? A tea company is a prospect that I know they will benefit from my service. A microphone company, they will not benefit from my service, so they are not a prospect, but that tea company is a prospect. Then a lead is someone who's expressed interest in my service. So I reach out to 20 tea companies, one says yes, they become a lead. They've expressed interest in my service. And maybe they say, yeah, I'm interested, but in 6 months. They're still a lead. We're gonna follow up with them in 6 months. Now a client is someone who's agreed to work with us. They expressed interest, we've done the sales call, they signed a contract, they are now a client. So I mentioned this module is big. We're gonna be learning a lot. So we're learning where to find prospects. We're gonna learn how to set up our emails properly. We're gonna learn how to write cold emails. We're gonna learn how to follow up and actually get sales calls with people. We're gonna walk through how to actually conduct a sales call, even if you feel awkward on the phone. We're gonna utilize scripts that anyone can follow. Then we'll go through the entire process of drafting and sending proposals. We'll talk about follow-up, about closing deals, about collecting payment. I'll then introduce something called a CRM. This is how you stay organized through all of this. This is where you organize your leads. This is where they live, right? If you're emailing hundreds of people, you gotta stay organized with that. You gotta know who says yes, who says follow-up in 3 months, who signs a deal, etc. Finally, we'll introduce a way to automate this entire process and have clients lining up to work with you. So we'll talk about cold email automation and really make this process easy for you. And just by knowing what this module teaches you, you'll be able to make a living from your passion to hit six figures, right? This stuff is, it works. If you put in the work, it works, and you'll be able to hit six figures inside of your creative business just by following this advice. Finally, we're going to introduce things like marketing, like case studies, Google reviews, and retainers so that you can start landing those really big deals. Retainers will unlock multi-month, year-long contracts with clients, and those tend to be huge numbers, right? This is how we grow a creative business. We start with no clients. We don't have any clients. Sucks, right? Then we start doing cold outreach. We start implementing the cold emails. We start sending proposals. We hop on those sales calls, right? People sign the proposals and we start getting clients. Then we start getting repeat clients and we start getting retainers. So we're gonna be doing less of cold outreach because we're gonna have repeat clients. Then clients begin coming to you and you get referrals. That's pretty great, right? Then you might not have to do any cold outreach. But when you get to this point, you're left with a decision. You can now either be a sustainable business as a solopreneur with very little cold outreach, or you can continue doing cold outreach, hire a team, and scale your company. So the hard part is just getting started. So if you have no clients, we're gonna do this cold outreach. We're gonna do it for 3 months, 6 months, 2 years. And from there, you're gonna build a very big business. You're gonna have hit six figures in your company. You're gonna have repeat clients, you're gonna have retainers. Then you're gonna have the clients coming to you, and then you'll make the decision. Do you wanna stay as a solopreneur, or do you wanna continue doing cold outreach, hire a team, and scale? And that's it. That is how you grow this creative business. This is what Creative Biz Launch is all about. Getting clients through cold outreach, then getting clients through repeat clients and retainers, and having clients come to you as you get bigger and bigger. And then you make the choice. Do we continue growing, or do we just stay happy making six figures as a solopreneur, right? So that's the hope of this module. It works if you do the work. It is a lot of work. It's fun. So I will see you in the next lesson.
I hope you found this video helpful and are feeling inspired to take your creative business to the next level. Remember, this was just one lesson from module 4 of Creative Biz Launch, and there's so much more to learn inside the program. If you're serious about starting your business or scaling it to over $100,000 a year, Creative Biz Launch is the way to go. We have dozens of testimonials and even a 100% money back guarantee. So you know it's the real deal. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week.